Hello and welcome to this video where I just want to do a bit of Path of Champions gameplay. I'm on my secondary account. Everybody playing LOL as a secondary account basically. And it's just like, didn't play ranked ever with this. But I basically want this Poro, and I need like a bunch more gems for that in base, so play. And I'll find some Path of Champions runs, and if you're new to this channel, I'm like a Masters player, Legends of Runeterra player who focuses on expeditions normally, but I wanted to put out one Path of Champions video. Not that big of a fan of that mode because I find it pretty easy and storm through it quite fast, and let's just get into it. This is not really supposed to be a guide, but more like a gameplay video. I'm just showcasing different stuff. Started with Caitlyn. Just do gangplank with Caitlyn first here. And if you don't know, I made a list of all of the different decks from all of the counters. I really like the first power, I like these champions because I like building super champions. It's like my most reliable strategy because most of the decks don't have hard removal. And I just like to talk through different missions, and of course we can't guaranteed win all of the counters, but we will certainly try. First one's pretty easy, just creates a random one cost in hand. Yeah, let's see. Missions. Yeah, this guy basically has nothing. It says 10 life and plays random mana costs and stuff. Should be sent against this. I wish the AI would be a little bit faster in action. It's like sometimes a little bit slow. Okay. It's like they have two warning shots in the deck, this is like unavoidable damage, unfortunately.
News from the Undercity ship, Detective Zane?
It's all in the report, Sheriff.
And I lose it as well, which is unfortunate.
Turning yourself in?
And you should always like worry about preventing damage. At some point you will pick up healing, and it doesn't matter how much damage you take, but in the earlier levels you should always like pass. Always try to prevent damage as much as possible.
A foray into the field? How exciting!
To open attack, they will just play random units, and then you can deal more damage than attacked. Fortunate, I guess.
Let's investigate.
Wasting our time with ephemeral units. Of course, we have the special unit in here, the double agent, which strike all players draw one. It's quite nice. There's the special card in the hooked help. Should have beforehand, so it doesn't. Agent doesn't go off. Like, I'm not a focused speedrunner or something, I just want to play this like fast. Get the second token again. I don't have any action except help in the deck. Yeah, down. Flash bombs happening. Yeah, I have a feeling that Caitlyn is a bit of a slower hero because you have other different nations going on. The Echo. But on this second account, I just have unlocked these PNC champions and the first few that you actually get. Random. This one, Capetler, seems decent. And reinforcements, let's pick up something nice here. So, Lunari Priestess gives us access to healing with the sisters potentially. Quinn. Quinn is like good if you summon a second Quinn. Fiona with the general technique if you healing well with the Lunari Priestess. Kind of healing. Fastest one here. Tend to prioritize these items over the spells. So because you never need to use. You're really dying. Okay, Jagged Butcher, basically a bunch of 1-drops. His power is that whenever next is, so like both players have like the Jagged Butcher effect, they have plus 1 to Thunder and Plunder. This one's like early game cards here. 1-drop, which is unfortunate, which take damage. But in the Spiritual region, you just have to damage sometimes. Start with this Jailbreak in hand. Get a good one. It's just one damage. And yeah. Yeah, it's flash bombs, they don't really have to deal with these powder cakes efficiently. They have like a mega drain, for example. One thing they have in their deck are like 4 times Citrus Courier, so you have to be worried about them rallying multiple times over and over. Get their ephemeral copies, or they earlier opponents always like programmed to attack every turn. Can work around that. And we take one more damage here to actually win this game. Time frame. Made my 1-1. Let's get Ranger down. Somehow both our flash bombs hit this 1-1. Like with the elusive. Yeah, this fight is like, this start is not going that great. Faster through it than that strength. Are you available? Kill it. Let's hope they don't get like an insane card here. I'll hunt them with. And there's like always a little bit of luck involved, so you can't just like build up the here. I'm going to shot this, but I pass bump as well. Flash bomb into the deck. Don't do anything, hopefully the flash bomb. 8, 10, quite lethal. Take this damage. Play like random one drops. I have scrap shot. Wouldn't have lethal them anyways. Like the Citrus Courier was talking about. It's like one of the things you have to worry about against this deck. It's just. Get plunder for the Nexus trigger. Play this because I'm a. Play a flash bomb, lose this and stuff, because we need 4 flash bombs, half of them. Still on the board. It's fine. Basically. Let's kill this so that they don't attack again. And. Let's move to our turn and attack. Play stuff. Nothing like the stink of blood and sweat. Let's get to it! Waste all of our time doing like random attacks. Ace palm. Like the AI has like emote triggers. It's the second encounter. Time of capture again. 2 of these in the deck, but this doesn't really matter if they have a powder cake. 7 or 8 kills anything anyways. And we get our first item on one of our cards. I think this is what this one is. Because we are like level 3 or something, so we can't like cut cards yet. And Lucian is pretty strong. I really like this focusing crystal. Lucian is strong. That's dice though. But he like with the ephemeral copy, I think thinking about champions is better here. Powder Monk is a little bit of a harder fight than the other one. We take a bit of damage from this one. And actually, like, this Mystic Shot and Static Shock are both fine versus Necton, not Renekton, Bank Plank, but I just take the Mystic Shot because it's better than early. So we definitely will take like 4 to 5 damage here against this Monkey Idol. We can't do anything other than a heal phase, so it doesn't really matter right now. This guy starts with a Monkey Idol. Name. Just start with a decent perf, let's get 2 drop. Effects happening. And Plunder Pogo can block this with the Academic. I don't know if this account is still one of it's always attacking. It's like it. Take at least 3 damage from this one, and they have multiple more monkey idols and like these monkey cards. So you are guaranteed to take some damage, and this is not a problem. Okay, and let's hope our doesn't actually taking some damage, but that's fine. Generally want to avoid taking damage, obviously. Just taking some in the middle of the way is fine, this is annoying. Gives them another card they can play here. Let's try to Mystic Shot here. Big thing, hopefully finding a champ. Yeah, let's just play Even Wand. It's fine, I would have blocked with this anyways. And let's just double block. The way there's like a setting in the menu that you can just click on cards, like it's called click to play. And that's just like way faster in my opinion than what you normally do. So yeah, let's play the academic. Because actually you can like pre-move this if they play like a card, then you can immediately already have already played this. Decent damage here. And Monkey Idol pretty annoying. You want to do like a perfect run of stuff or worry about your health. Have trouble against Gangplank, you should avoid Monkey Idol. Against Swain, for example, you heal against after Swain anyways. Put more Puff Caps into the deck and 2 damage. And try to hit some Puff Caps to kill this Monkey Idol. Turn off Monkey Idol. And yeah, this fight is just mostly annoying. There's nobody really lose to those, they just like summon idols over and over. Hit a Flishboom Trap to kill one of these. Oof. Get the flip is nice. I don't really want them to summon random. Wait, did all 3 hit this one? Okay, I don't really like how these traps work, but this should just be lethal. Let's see. And like, I don't want them to play random monkey cards here and deal more damage to me. It's fine. Open attacking. Okay, took some 5 damage. It's fine. You have to heal anyways because we're at a low level, and actually healing doesn't affect your score at all early levels. The only thing that matters is for your score, it's ending. And let's see if we get something good. No. Should we take the most playable card? Of course, the Ephemeral is terrible, Father Guardian is terrible. Scout unit. 250 gold, what is this one? This is the 1 cost one. I like the 1 cost. What shop is like? Wrong. I got 1 minute. 2 is fine. So expensive. Take Legion. And let's take this heal because we can't do anything else here. And reach down Swain. Swain is pretty interesting that he doesn't have any removal. He just has a Death's Hand. And like obviously Swain and Ravenous Flock if he flips. Or if he like have Swain on the board. But otherwise he has like Whispered Words and the Savage Reckoner, but basically at all can if you get like the Super Champions, which we have, City Rush down mostly. There's random Noxus units and Fusion, and actually keep this Fist because I want to Turbo Flip Fusion. Let's do the Academic instead. We have a good card, I usually play the Jailbreak here. And I hit this guy. Yeah, I think it's fine. I think this 1 health matters at all. They might like not block for some random reason. Let's hope they're not overtaken and let us play our Illusion. And they should have only have 1 copy of Death's Hand in the hand in the deck. They don't have that immediately. And I think like sometimes it opens auto attacks. What I mean with auto attack is that it's like programmed to attack even if you have an ephemeral unit on the board. Some AIs are like smarter, most of them are just like, even the earlier levels are just like really stupid. It's always attacking to you. And with this one actually, I'm going to run out Fizz, because he summons another ephemeral copy of it, and this helps him take Illusion. And if they actually block stupidly, the Illusion this turn, good. Block with this next turn. Illusion in general is pretty good because it needs a specific answer. And these AI decks aren't really programmed to heal Illusion. Veteran is like annoying. Let's just block this with a Space Shield. Area, let's say, not Space Shield. Actually, I wanted this unit to die so that my Illusion flips. It's fine. Now we can act like this Quinn. Basically, level Quinn up in 1 turn. This is always something you should look for in making this program to play Swain here. So we are just like... I'm not programmed to play Swain. guess. Right. Now we get this attack, which basically readies for us. Something will die for the Lucian. This is an ephemeral unit. Flip solution, then our ephemeral copy of the card will actually rally. Now we can scout attack. Taking this out as well. Click doesn't really matter because we can just kill them this turn. And then our real attack, almost leveling up our Quinn. And then just killing Svein here. This is how I imagine it, just like speedrunning through this. And it's pretty easy if you know what the decks are doing. Which you can do as well, and the list is public, so you can take a look at this as well if you struggle with a specific. I will post a link in the description. Our champions. This doesn't do anything. Just picked up a champion power in the first one, so I pick up my champions. Thunder's strongest enemy is always pretty strong. Take this one. Or rather, prioritize the items over the spells. Because with items you can hit your champions, and having super champions doesn't always win you the game, but if you take the ephemeral champion, for example, then it pretty oftentimes does. And let's beat up this Glory Seeker, its units get bigger once strikes for 5 plus damage, they bigger. Which can be a problem sometimes, but usually it isn't. Let's hope they don't play an amazing 1 cost unit. As we run out this Fizz, we can flip this Lucian later on. And yeah, just block with the ephemeral copy. Late fragment. Doesn't really matter that much. And Lucian. And they again have no hard removal. They have 2 copies of Wild Claws. But it will take some time before they can kill my Lucian with Wild Claws. Block here. Pretty much always blocking. And yeah, we take push in 10 damage. Yeah, Blade Squire is totally fine. I will actually just go for. Can just sacrifice this to it. That's fine. Rune Weaver. Get all of these random Blade Fragments. Let's keep my Lucian here. She will be leveled up next time with the Jinx. So, Barrier and Ephemeral interact in this way that the Ephemeral unit strikes and thus dies. So. This way, if they sacrifice the unit, it flips Lucian. And Lucian, as always, is one of the strongest champions we can roll. Can sometimes just randomly die, so we have to be a little bit careful against the Gangplank. Would definitely like to have some Challenger on this Lucian, or some Challenger card in general. Lay out this Badger Bear, program to attack, and then we kill them. Okay, I'm just immediately, so I don't waste my time. Yeah, let's take the Quinn. Don't attack, which means they probably just die. Should do the scout attack. I guess I should summon Quinn. To make sure they're dying, they can't really play wild. Can play Wild Claws on this one. That should be pretty. Now we can just attack with everything. This one to make sure it dies and get the rally trigger, and we can attack with the Quinn again. And this one just this way they just concede. And nice. So no damage taken here, which is always the optimal route to go. And nice healing, that's always nice. Always take the healing cards, and this just draws me a champion. Also upgrade, I like to stack upgrades on the same card again, these random stats don't do anything. By the way, the time you spend out here in the shop doesn't actually matter. And, ooh, this is nice, and copies of the Fallen Feline. Oh, I can't afford, no, 5 gold! 5 gold off. Is there another shop coming? See? Yes, I don't want to spend all my money here. What's this? Spotbot, this is a Rolls, so that's this. Let's go to the Riptide Rex. Cryptid Wreck is basically a joke encounter where it deals 7 damage to random stuff each turn. And it's just like a swarm deck with Riptide Rex. And again, no interaction or card removal. So yeah, our deck should just cruise through here. I will actually. It's fine, keep rolling feline. Doesn't really do that much because they just like damage each side of the turn. Actually, I'm not going to play it unless they play a unit. Let's summon a unit that summons another unit here. Like this, it will just die at the start of their turn. You have to be a little bit careful here with Lucian. Just want to have a Lucian die, obviously. But also don't want to really take damage, so I will take the 50-50. Don't hit me, but them. And we can get our Lucian train going. Of course, if Lucian gets randomly hit by this. Missiles, then it's unfortunate. But we have like other units as well on the board. It was unfortunate getting the Hexed Crystal, but they probably won't ever draw this. Get the Flash Troops into the deck and still like leave a unit behind. Again, they play such a swarmy strategy that they basically always have units. And it's really hard to lose against this encounter. I Navigator. No, an Elusive. Ah. That is too fast. Block this. And I not block this Elusive, but like build up a peacemaker. No, my Lucian died. Shouldn't as well. It's fine. Skull attack here. And just salvage. Hate how slow the toss animation is. Oh, that's good. And they play the flight again. Skull attack and then normal attack. Full attack. Yeah, but of damage in. They kill a random unit, but if you are like ahead on the board, it doesn't matter if they kill your random units. Yeah. Cards out. Now we'll use Mecha this one so that they don't attack, maybe.
Here's my calling card. A win streak.
What I would usually do if I would be able to not just heal at like a higher level, I would stall out until I find this Jinx and actually heal up, but like you can literally not do anything else that heal front of Gangplank. So that's heal. Like the random blocks. And some fighting happen. Again, this is just a random swarm deck. One of our units dies here. Still got the Skull attack. All the time. Play out Quinn. Ah, Flash Bomb. Okay. Like, add some, like, skip animation button. Make it interesting. Okay, random Quinn happening. Second copy of Vela. But still a ton of damage. And we will heal up this damage anyways before we go to final boss, so I don't need to stall out the game here or anything. Heal up this a little bit by killing this unit. No, the Jinx! That doesn't matter. Shen. So yeah, pretty fast first run. Let's see how long it takes for us to beat Gangplank. I'm a little bit afraid of Gangplank. Because he has these dread rays and stuff, so we might lose if we draw poorly. They like shoot down all of our Lucians, they don't have that much interaction. We can also just combo Gangplank down and kill him pretty quickly. This one's pretty good, the random spell and cast. We don't cast that many spells, but we have to take one basically. Let's see if we can pick up like some interaction here. Shuffle two copies into my deck, Scout, Peddler. You can do, by the way, is you can buy a reroll token and then reroll here. I like... doesn't throw me cards, so I don't really like this one. Reroll. Area. Eh. Buy this one and roll again, because nothing else is coming. Oh, we don't have no money anymore. Make this bigger. All of our money. And we can't do anything else except for healing here. Our level. And let's see if this deck is good enough to beat Gangplank. Gangplank will definitely not draw and kill you. But we can just reverse not draw. Have like our Lucian flip pretty early on. And again, I'm not trying to like do this 100% without ever losing. It's just like for farming these crystals. Like playing pretty fast. Out on these cards. To find our early game, our one cost units for example. And now one thing I want to do here is play this Fizz next turn. Another one I guess. I guess we play this turn then. Gangplank sometimes attacks with everything. Oftentimes he doesn't. And the thing we can do here is we can counter a naked raid with our Fizz. I like the Fizz. What you should generally do against Gangplank is always kill these barrels as soon as possible, because he will always try to use them, oftentimes try to use them. Then if he doesn't have barrels on the board, he isn't scary. He has 4 copies of Dreadway, 4 copies of the Riptide Rex, so be aware of that. And I don't really want to play this here, because they might just make it rain. Double up, they tend to do this, so now we can Ballistic Shot this guy. Counter this, this is why I really like Fizz in this first encounter. Get one of these. This just counters the spell. Because our crystal is pretty strong. We have the mana anymore to crank us. Don't need to play our Jinx yet, because we can play her when we need the life gain. There's the Vampiric Scepter on it. Now we can just Scald Attack here. I'd still on the top deck to make it rain. Normally they would have played make it rain by now. I didn't play around it anymore. But they top decked it. Happens. I removed these emotes because I find them a little bit annoying. Funny at first, but if you played it like a million times already. A little bit annoyed now because they top decked this card. Not sure how like Gangplank behaves. I think he's like almost programmed to attack each turn. Especially if he pushes like damage. Quite nice. They have 4 Gangplanks in total. So it's just we don't have any other scout units, so we can just scout attack down this powder keg here. With another scout unit. So we do that then. And I want to get Caitlyn going. Oh, but this is fine. Scout attacks are pretty strong. Dead men tell my tale. And yeah, they might have another Make It Rain, which would be fortunate, but again, it would have to be in the left parts, and they have 2 copies of Make It Rain in total, so pretty unlikely. Don't have it. I want to be a little bit careful here, we don't want to randomly push them under 30, so I will just attack with one of them, like under 20. Less than 20, so we could have put them at 20, but we don't basically give them a random dreadway unless we have a commanding board position already. We'll have a commanding board position next turn. Map here, which is fine. Get a warning shot. And I want to have board space here, my problem. Just now I kind of want to keep this as well. I'm just going to play a Caitlyn. So I kind of want to squin next turn. Double agent is fine. Us here and get down our Quinn. Again, the only space you have to worry about. I have like Scrapshot as well. Usually, it's even easier to like mill out Gangplank instead of like actually deal with him. Pali, it's like annoying. Fine. It's a pretty high life total. Now we can just do our Scout Attack. Can't block with Gangplank because he's stunned. We played another unit out here. Yeah, we might just get obliterated here next turn. Wow. See that coming. Oh, that killed our 5-5. They rarely like line this up so that the Lipper deck actually gets like the full power off the usually play it as 6-4. And with this one I kinda like to play this. Oh, we get Fizz down as well. Because it can counter like the random stuff they might have next. Powder is fine, we can just kill that. Happy that they played this. So, heck. Let's investigate. And this one. Also er hat einen kleinen Block. Ich gebe einen Card. Yum. They get the red way now. It's a little bit terrifying, but we have a fizz on the board, so we might be able to counter some of these terrifying spells. The Shooter does. Only not even close to leveling up Gangplank here. How exciting. Of course, GP can deal a lot of damage, but we have 8 points of life in our hand with the Jinx. And this is the second GP. Let's see if we come out of this turn ahead. We basically won the match. Double Dreadway is like super scary, not gonna lie. We'll definitely attack here. Let's see what they are choosing. Prank coming down. Either that much. Let's just make sure to take down these Dreadways as much as we can. By taking this Dreadway down first, we can guarantee that this doesn't do as much damage. We still take 7 damage, but we can back up with our defenses. And yeah, let's just play our first Jinx out right away. Back up to 25 we go, we have access to still excited now. And by the board is so weird right now. Another got excited. This doesn't quite take out the Dreadway. It's not ranked this one. Still fine to play it out. Again, we have the get excited, we have to play something scary. Bank attack down this barrel. Take a little bit more information on what's going on. Grifter again. A bit annoying. But we can do here. It's basically attack with everything. It's on Silas Barrier. We not with this one. The other guys. They are probably programmed to block stuff. And this allows us to kill this Gangplank. Got the other Jinx. They just decided to flip Jinx. They deal double damage. It's fine. We'll deal with all of the Gangplanks, basically have no problem. And it's just as well to draw another card next turn. The Jinx flip. Game's dragging out a little bit. Still in the winning position, I would say. I have an answer to the second Make It Rain. Maybe they didn't draw it yet. Get the rocket here. Just play out. A bunch of damage and half of the board. Warning shot us, dealing 8 to the Nexus. A lot. We with half of the board. And they attack poorly so that we can take this out before they actually get Gangplank hit in. And our open attack should just kill them. Gangplank flip. It's done. No. Go in. Wouldn't have a good way to interact with this. And beat Gangplank, of course not the highest rating ever. Random stuff happening. But did it in the end. Like, I really don't like these aggressive strategies of this Gangplank. It's way more consistent if you just like mill him out and never give him this Dreadway. Even if you give the Dreadway, you don't have that much interaction. It's still. Okay, we just like versus Caitlyn, that is a little bit difficult at higher levels. Let's find out here. Banshee Veil. Jinx for featuring. Yeah, leveled it up. Rerolls. Start with a random item. Not for relic. I think I only have like 2. Especially as I take this. The other account I have like unlocked way more. And let's just move to Ezreal. I've heard many people saying that they find Karma overpowered. Let's see if we can just take Karma down here. Basically, Karma starts with 10 mana gems, so you really want to have some kind of late game ability, kind of like Duelist Karma, but this armor is just too. This armor is one of the strongest powers, like non epic powers in the game. Just invalidates many of the opponent's cards. Be able to pick up some more late game at some point. So basically, all we are doing now is searching for either late game or for a way to remove Karma. Just keep the curve here. This Hextech Observatory is a little bit annoying and that it plays a lot of spells. It often takes a lot of turns to get killed. Starting with Fearsome here, that start with any mana. Yeah, this can be an annoying encounter because they have like a ton of Mystic Shots and random stuff like that. Shouldn't really take damage, should take a bunch of time to play out our cards. I would really love to draw Caitlyn at some point. And yeah, they will Mystic Shot our units anyways during combat, so we will just play out our cards here. And that Jolt is like a exclusive card, it just deals 1 damage for all followers. And back in the proper order, card draw effect. And shoot us down anyways. It's basically how this matchup goes. You just they shoot you over all the time and you get damage in. But I don't think you can really do this. Pretty slow. Because you can lose to anything or poorly. If you ever find our Caitlyn, it should be fine. And the remove spells, I'm still continue searching for Caitlyn. Big shot. How the deck is basically the shots of random stuff like that. Really didn't attack. I've brought my books. Hope that's alright. Okay. Bruce Bears. Which fun and interactive. Played this one out first because I thought they could have that. Come on, people. Let's make tomorrow today. And yeah, we're not doing too great here. Yeah, we find Caitlyn, Caitlyn flip. That's this game. A 1-1. Come on, like this is not a fun encounter at all. Never had problems with this one before, but it's just annoying. Shoot you down like every like a random generated spell. And they said I was dangerous. I'm double agent. Literally just remove the spells. Lock, prevent some damage. 11. You draw Caitlyn, please. Cast that. Caitlyn literally hiding. There we go, we even have a space shield on her. We have activated zero traps. Fine, they are programmed to block with that. Scoping the area. Kill it for free. Peacemaker protocol. And yeah, like this just takes forever for no reason at all. Kill this next time we get this mana we found. Gets hit by these flashbomb traps. Just a one. Fine. It's transforming this into this, we don't want that to happen. This to like re. Come on! What is this? Just draw normally. Here's my calling card. Guess we have to take 7 here. Fortunate. Let's get to work. Take this free block though. Rather like a bad start, but usually like draw Caitlyn anytime earlier than turn late. Shouldn't have any problems with this one. Just one flash, we have 10, we have more cards, flash from the deck than cards. Crazy. And Sevi. Kill this right now. Crazy. Caitlyn back into the deck. Draw a bunch of cards. Hopefully get 6 or something. 4. Crazy. How we not? We never had problems with this counter before. Caitlyn just sucks. Not sure. But this is means they die, right? Whoever survives here. Unfortunately, they waste all of our traps here. Maybe they attack into our Caitlyn. Let's curse them. Take a lot of damage, fortunately. Yeah, weird. I never had this problem with this observatory. But it's fine. We'll just pick up healing and fine afterwards. Very weird. I never took that much damage against the observatory before. Another case closed. But you saw we just didn't hit any champions. Kind of our one drops. Okay. Akshan, pretty nice. And we want some late game here. We can stack up on more actions. Like a little bit unfortunate. I think I have to reroll here because none of these beat the karma pretty well. Perfect. Maybe it's like the perfect counter to karma. Okay, let's go to the item here. This Dragonling fight is pretty hard, so I want to just go for a Jamie Dada. And unfortunately, we didn't pick up any life gain. Action doesn't give us life gain, so we just have to power through until we get some life gain. And just see how it goes. Do. Cards. Again, you're not guaranteed to like, win every time. You get the web. Don't really like this encounter because it's like so hard to see what they actually generate. And yeah. Guy. This fearsome high roll is just makes this effect. We see this with the next one, the one that generates last random one once. Random 2 drop here. And they hit this with the random 2 drop. Not our day today. And they have the grow in ally 4-4. Wow. Really not our day today. It's a random, this effect basically is a random thing, either the plus 4 plus 0, the grow, or... I think what I do want to do is either grow the wrong one, which is nice. Now we can actually take down this 4-4 because it deals too much damage. Or Caitlyn out. And it's really weird how I didn't play Caitlyn before, by the way. This is my first Caitlyn run. I find it really weird how this is like actually somewhat challenging. Finally healing yet. Okay, let's hope you block with this. Just don't block. Why are they playing so good? Definitely this is more, this is harder than the first one, the first type of legends. Quick attack, that's annoying. I think I will just jump block here. Before this, and then they will play the quick attack. Stick shot the guy. Pretty annoying. What we can. Action is good. I don't need rules to know good for quick attack. Okay, that doesn't do anything. Nice. And we can play our double agent, hopefully get them with their own suit up. Out, that's fine with me. We will attack with everything. This perhaps first, they might block with this, and then we suit up. Valuable to kill this random quick attack guy and to our action alive. They are taking a lot of random damage here that was unavoidable. Let's see, works out in the end. The deck is basically random cards. What to say about it? Generated mana, you see again how good this minus one minus zero power is. Let's play this out. Let's miss the shots. Oh, it's a they have to go for. Block everything. And yeah, just down. Play this. Hope this dies to our flash bombs at some point. No flash bombs. Just attack here. Jump block. Interesting. I don't have Elvis Ferros in it. So. Planting more flash bombs into the deck. Hopefully. Take care of this Albus Ferros on the draw. So we might be able to static shock it on the Rosie plus 4 plus 4 again. Still no need to get elusive. Hope we kill this. Of course we don't. Of course they hit the plus 4 plus 4. Ah, this game just doesn't like us today. Just doesn't like us today. Okay. Here comes down. Definitely a rough start for us. Fine. Stuff is happening. Action. Nice. So palace. Absolute. How did we not hit any flash bombs? Here. Come on! Why do you have to be so annoying? Then we will give our Caitlyn initiative. Buff up our half board. Attack here. Damage. Hopefully you hit some flash bombs, man. Hilarious. Yeah. Say about that. Or flash bombs. Watch that for us. It's fine because we flip Anivia next turn. Hope we at least hit a flash bomb now to kill this 5-1. But I play a unit first and we can avalanche. Or get this flip finally.
I aim to win, and my aim is excellent.
Second Albus Ferros thing, the end of the world. One more damage. Okay, and this should just kill them. Smart. We have to block this because it actually just dies. We have to block it. Caitlyn. Yeah, taking a lot of random damage, definitely. I'm looking forward to finding some healing. This fight's just not really going our way right now. Next one should be free with the random elusives. And we can go from. Healing, heals, and expensive stuff actually. Down is any Corinth, like nice. What is it good in? I think I will go for healing. Didn't hit it. That's unlucky. Like you normally find some healing. point. Pick up this culling strike for the Israel, I think. Not going too great. Let's see. Again, no healing, lifesteal. Guess the draw on our Peacemaker is the strongest. This guy should just behave. Take a look at this card shop. This guy should just be free with our power. We just done a bunch of 1-1s and 2-1s. And makes them elusive and stuff. Be able to deal nicely. The power of this one is pretty random. It's just like, let's get either stunned or get elusive. Those units. 2 or less health, and he just has a bunch of 2 or less health units. So pretty random. But and okay, Demic first. Right. 1-1 or 0-1 better. This is like 3. All of the 1-1s are just 0. There's like 4 skeptic assemblies that makes like 2 1-1s. This card. Just not like. Officer is nice, I think that's more valuable than playing our double agent here. This and then trade my Mystic Shot for this Aeronaut, because it's like one of the only does. Seems okay. I don't want to take any more damage. Like, not permanently lose this power of the counter. You may lose it for one round. Avalanche is also like. Answer to stuff. Stun, so we have to play a unit to block this crush bot. One of us got stunned, but the other didn't. So click here first, draw our card to find better answers for stuff. Akshan is nice. Flash bomb trap actually had us. Damage to our board. You can just trade for this.
Good people don't look the other way.
Play the Peacemaker. Let's just do that, draw a card, some flash into the deck. Should be nice. Do-do. Random stuff happening. And we have an idea on our hand. Mystic Shot action, which is fine. And they kinda hit. Not stunned and elusive, so we have hit. But now because it doesn't get hit by Avalanche, then we don't want to take any more damage.
I'm on it.
Fine. Fine. Annoying. I guess I just Avalanche. I would take one damage if I wouldn't Avalanche. Take one damage. Yeah, and if we're coming down next turn, it have something. Yeah, this does. See how good this power is against these guys. Like it. And for example, against the final boss, Ezreal, just can't hit you. Like, Ezreal is flipped, he can't hit you. It's so nice. And Nivea, which is annoying. And they don't have anything. What? Doesn't matter. But yeah, Nivea, not. Ezreal, not really something you can easily rush down. It's more of a late game counter. So patient. Alex here. Alex strike on this
3-3.
Immediately. Might not attack. And yeah, managed to not take any damage in this fight. Can't play the second Olivia because we have this one on the board. Pack in. And yeah, this takes quite some time. Get this finally. It's first before the effects go off. Not sure about the order, now it's 3 attack and can't be affected anymore. Shoot a random unit, and this is over. Let's see how it ended. Fine. And it's one again stunned. Let's play Caitlyn out.
Well, what have we here? scoping the area.
Should still be able to beat Karma if you draw like decently. I just to talk about here, which pool was it? Hard. Big damage from what? Well, they have the front speed. Deal with it, take it out. Should have like random skeptic assemblies and stuff. So. Yeah. And the vehicle comes back next to the base. Pass. Not that exciting to fight. They draw a thing. What? Ah! It's fine. Sorry. Ching. Fine. Just raise it for one turn. Go here first. And guys, we take a red card. Play out our units because it's the board.
Suspicious activity detected just right outside the station. Stay on him.
Backup's on the way. Holding it back. Like, Olivia's definitely got the choice to go for if you want to speedrun this. Like, taking forever for all of the animations. Now that it will block everything. Yeah. Before then again. But again, if you want to beat Karma, you just take up one of these late game champs. Probably the weakest late game champ versus Karma. She doesn't kill Karma on her own. Yeah. Let's make sure they don't attack us here. Guard out. And hope we'll take for the end. What I will do for saving some time is actually not attacking with this one. Oh! Yeah, animation. What I will do here for like speeding up the thing a little bit is not attack with Olivia, because we don't get this animation. Again, I'm not really caring about these ratings, but I don't want 5 hours.
Until our paths cross once
and let's see. And we still don't get anything like this. Aloof Travelers draw. Rerolls, so let's go for the card shop and look for something. Any healing at all? No! Lucky. We'll actually go for the reroll token and roll here. Try and find any. Oh, this is like a pretty terrible healing card, but at least it's a healing card. So I think we won. Run. Let's see. Pick up all of you and summon a star from my spot that I need. Well, and yeah, we can't do anything here other than healing. Karma always is a little bit random, comes down to the opening hand, we find our Nivea. This is definitely not the best deck to beat Karma with, so I wouldn't be surprised if we lose here. But we definitely have a chance, especially with our Nevergly Collector that starts a free attack. Pretty terrible on Nevergly Collector to start a free attack, but take everything. So yeah, it all comes down to the opening hands. Do they have a Will of Aeonia? Do we find our Nivea? We find our Nivea, we find our card draw. So, but they have the attack token, unfortunately. One thing you want to do with Karma, they always play out the Karma first. Actually, have both Karmas in hand, Karmas in total. So, I will just play my Aloof first to try and get rid of an Aurora Borealis. This is the most expensive, like the Warmasters call it the most expensive one. Aurora Borealis is the second most expensive. And now they have like tapped underneath here. Mana for. They still have Will of Aeonia. It's just one of the Nivea. Don't have mana for Will of Aeonia, is what I wanted to say here. Should be attacking with both. They have like 5 Eye of the Dragons in their deck. Okay, thank you for doing that, Karma. Very. This for two. Can open kill this Karma. Get another one. Which is fine. Just have to grind through. Actually. Yeah, Flash Freeze comes down. I got the first karma. I got this one, it's like the only one copy of Feral Mystic in the deck. The only overwhelm unit we have. Second karma in hand. They have no hard removal of this one, they have a Shatter, which they can cast. Would be unfortunate. But I will. They also have Deny. Now they are under Deny. No, they are not Deny, so play another card. Now, yes, don't spare this deck. Let's play one of these guys first. Let's see what happens. They have Deny. Palm, interesting. Now they're out of mana. We can second Karma. Now this fight is just over. Let's draw the third one immediately. Take out these karmas. Let's the killers this turn exactly this attack token. Our power helps us to not die here. Totally fine. If Ionia, fine. I will play my free attack Navigate Collector. Gain some life, units dying. Out of mana here. Can't develop any more units. And
turning yourself in.
This. And then you can clear the board if I need to. Do no hair, doesn't do anything for them. Get a double agent. And again, was really good to get this draw. Always try to go for value against the Nikita. Well, against Karma I should say. But it's so annoying, I was the same flash boom, like flash boom can hit the same unit. Kill the one unit, like ready yet. Die to Olivia. Again, just over. Do damage to the board. Play some random Poros and maybe buff them up.
Opportunities double edged.
One thing I would like.
I won't stand by.
Pass here. Out of the fluff is like a little bit annoying because even if it's like just one, it still gets back to the other card. Also annoying, but it can't strike anymore. It's, you see how strong this minus one minus zero power is. It just invalidates total cards. And here we'll just go for the avalanche. Happy that our own units die because it gives us some life back. Then to have this. That's fine. Anything value in the deck anymore. Caitlyn flip. Cut draw card.
When crime calls, a reply is proper.
Out of the fluff. Oof.
Made it. Yay.
But our stuff did it.
All. Nice. Now let's play our second open attack, Neverglade Collector. Getting all the life gain. Attack this unit, which is fine. Do here is just attack with everything. It will still die to the Caitlyn if it blocks it. Apo attacks are like a thing. Drowned under our life gain now. Over and over.
Might help, might not.
Like a one-off in their deck, the Emerald Awakener. Not afraid of.
Spirit gives to those who listen.
Let's see here. Random stuff off. Nothing really matters. Let's win this game back. So what to talk about? Karma's deck has like all of these dragon cards basically. And yeah, Karma deck has all of these random Poros snacks. Four times Aurora Borealis in the deck. Okay, that's like 9. Oh no, I should have killed the next. It's just like. Again, it's basically much in a hurry. Again, it's pretty hard to. Right? You basically have to hit that infinite combo. Like, get this S speed rating. trying our best here to play as fast as possible. But against Karma, because it's stolen. It's alright. Another thing you can do is to mill out Karma, which is quite funny. Nothing to be concerned with anymore. This Karma fight was a little bit scary in the first time, but we prepared for it accordingly, so go back up to 18 life. And the burst spells. We block. Attack again. Ladder. Night roll. Stuff. Attack again. Trying to do this like fast as possible because it's only is just like they don't have any tons of money. They have 2x shadow in their deck. That's not a real answer. Just have a second Nivea in hand. And yeah, Karma, a little bit annoying I would say, but not overpowered by any. It takes a lot of time to play all of its spells. Now we kill everything again. Eventually they just run out of stuff to do. That is fine. Right one unit, flash bombs in it. Might even be like milling out Karma here. Playing random spells open Sonic Wave. Take out what? Next again. Yeah. And again. Trying to give up my Caitlyn here, we have a second one. Punch my enemy hard. Show her. Boss. Caitlyn deals some damage here. Never get collector steal damage. And the other Caitlyn out. Daring Pogo comes out. And then Pogo better. As long as we can jump block them. Put out the game against them. Reparate the power. They have 2x discipline, by the way. 2x discipline fortitude. Spot the lethal here, we stick shot our own unit. Stick shot our own unit again, or we stick shot them. Like the more obvious version of the lethal. And Karma down easily. I think I already have lost once to Karma. I was really unlucky, basically one killed. Which I would say, like, my experience Karma isn't that hard. Plan ahead and think. Brain. Okay, both of these are terrible. Let's take the champion with decent stats. And power. That's good. That's me. And we have a thing. And diversity of Piltover. This is basically a choke encounter in the Interpret Marina. Takes a long time to basically do all the animations, but the deck is just a choke. Can't lose against this one, so we take this easy route. Probably faster to go for the Blade Twirler, but you might actually take damage against Blade Twirler, and preventing damage should be one thing to always go for. Like random elusive, so we'll keep Culling Strike. General this deck, Mulligan doesn't matter against this deck, by the way, but we get a random hand each time. So yeah, pretty. You have to talk a little bit through this animation stuff. Basically, the power is that you. Player shuffles the hand into the deck and gets another one. Get a new hand each time, which is pretty pointless. You're just given low power and same effect basically. Now we just have to wait for the animations over and over. Let's just do some damage here. One. Hope they don't get jailbreak to get one damage. What's this? Water pass on. Okay, run out of Caitlyn, run out of Caitlyn.
Well, what have we here?
So yeah, what can we talk about? Really like the new design of Caitlyn. Just like pretty.
So long, City of Progress.
Not that. For the old Caitlyn, she just had like basically no clothes, and this one is like pretty beautiful. And. Action coming down here and we can shoot this one and then make it a loose. Make them attack first and have to sacrifice this for value. Action dying doesn't matter. Once again, we want to make them attack here so that sacrifice this don't. And again, this is so pointless. Like if it would be like a puffcap deck or something, that would make sense. Just going to get my life gain online while I can. Block it. I have like first bills and like program to always copy that with the perfectionist. Basically the whole deck is just like random units. No real story at all. So Percival is a pretty cool card. Like a cat. Let's see. Not the story behind it. Just trying to talk through it a little bit. This is like the most annoying unit because it actually can give them a real card. Find some Percival, which is nice. And yeah, play out Hulu. Let's get a good board. And it's really, really impossible to lose to this guy. You lose to this guy, you were ever either at like one life, then you went into this fight. Something horrendously wrong. Which point should be? I feel like at one life, when this fight starts, I would be. Can accept this. To this, as it's just like a waiting game. Chattison is the Coral Creatures card. You can see some more of the garbage deck, counterfeit copies, and Percival. Most of these encounters on the Karma level are just like random stuff. Easily out value once we have like. Kill some of the units, up a little bit. This takes a lot of time to break through, basically. I really like this Karma level too much. I like it because it's something different. It's not just like you get rushed down or you rush them down. But I find it pretty slow and annoying slow, so. Hey, happens again. Could you purchase? Hopefully they don't pokey stick our face. Annoying. Right, like an attack here, but. Snaker. We have this one with the Cryptologist. And interesting attack, I'd say. Yes, I block. Oh, you got me. Got me so good. Now we can attack with like a 4-4 egg. But like a 3-4 egg already. Unfortunately, we can't win the game before we have to watch a Nivea animation. So that we don't have to watch the draw animation. So, even these cards are like the only like annoying thing they can generate for you. No, I got to get my life gain card. This play. Should have paid more attention, but like this fight again. Shouldn't give up your life gain card, but we have a second one if we need to. Take any damage. Except if they roll like a two-shot barrage here. Be annoying. Trollfish doesn't do. It's picked. Bells. It's nice. Aloof. More of their cards in their hand. Vectors. Deer flip. This just takes a bunch of time. Trollfish is such a cool design, I find. Really like the lurkers actually, because they're something completely new, like the top of the deck. It was like manipulation before, if you think of the name as Sensei's Divining Top. More flip animation. Really like Caitlyn flip as well, with, like flowers on the side. It's basically storming into. I think this strategy would be to play cards here, but play cards. Would be faster if you like speed up this draw animation. But I guess you can shoot like back in the face. Mystic shot maybe that's up a little. Play out some cards. Some guy. Like on Reddit just said Discord. This guy would be like perfectly playable now with the 2-2 model. Definitely disagree with that. That's basically just playing cards here because I want to or have this animation be faster. Animation.
See you soon, friendos.
So I'm aware I'm avalanche my own units. Doesn't matter. I just want through animation to be like faster. Maybe that was stupid. Double. Still now. There's my second. Oh, we actually attack them. Let's hope that I just concede here. Okay, all the flips. Oh, now you're playing cards. Still die, but out of spite here they might die. Let's see if we can find our Neverglade Collector. This guy's actually in the deck, so I didn't take the crystal, but I think about how we could actually take damage here. This is of course terrible. Never take damage. Let's draw now. Play some cards. Find my Neverglade Collector. And life back up. Spells. Spells. Fine. And oh, let's see if we can find our Neverglade Collector here. Again, it's not a big deal because we can just heal up before the final fight. I don't have anything else to do. It's fine, because I'm epic. Shellfork, don't Shellfork, please. One of these guys. Oh, they copied them with the action this time around. And they don't have any hard removal, so this just wins me the game. Faster than taking the leap as well. Okay, finally got the losing counter. Took 4 damage because we were stupid and gave up our Neverglade Collector. That doesn't matter. So yeah, 2 champions. So, we... Oh, life gain. Life gain. We don't really need the money here. And see what the price of the Piltover is like. Oh, we get another power. That's actually really cool. How many do they have? 350. Can't do this, but we can do this one to heal our units each attack. So good. Cast summon a follower. We don't have any mana anyway. Gold token. And another shop. So Academic. Academic can rush you down, but we have a bunch of avalanches with life gain on them. Fine. Again, life gain is the key for all of these runs. Academic coming up. This up. Yeah, we're actually hard mulligan for avalanche. We tend to just spam the board pretty quick, random stuff. But you don't find it. Once you stabilize against the academic, you see how good our power is again. And the avalanche. First, this doesn't like the avalanche, so they can play it out. Hate them into running more stuff, playing more stuff. And actually have that many created cards in the deck. Oh, the gotcha. This here, man, a gotcha. And next time, just avalanche stuff away, heal up. Full. Okay, both players draw one. It's fine. Just pass here. No, what the heck? Not milling me. Guess I will have to play a card here now. Akshan. And the zero mana gotcha. Yeah, like, it's annoying. Doesn't it? And again, zero attack on board. Let's have our avalanches to up here. Do we want to immediately play these? It's fine. More units next turn. Can't progress there yet. Dude. Again, our life turtle. We can take as much damage as we want because we can. Neverglade Collectors. Overspeed with energy. Come on! Like, we have 3 copies of this in the deck. All of them. And I guess we drew all of our late game as well. Early game cards, not playable cards.
But our stuff did it.
Didn't. Nice, got rid of one progress day. Care about this fight yet. Skip the attack, that's fine. Have this. I will just play a second avalanche here. Take any elusive damage, trade out for this. Run. See, they have no cards in hand anymore. Takes like 7 more damage. Then back up. Vector. And you have to make sure to not mill them out accidentally. Livia is pretty good here. Kills this unit. And I think we need one more turn and then we can get our free attack Navigator Collectors online. It's like the most terrible item, like Hammer would be worse. But it's pretty hard to get. They have like 3 progress days, I think. Pretty close to milling out already. Bit scary. Yeah, they top deck one immediately. Like scary in the sense that they run out of stuff before we can build back up fully. House farms, usually those flash bombs are pretty good against this deck, I would guess. Like flash bombs. Atro. That makes a lot of sense. AI. Yeah, and we just lock everything.
Turning yourself in?
Guess we shouldn't. It's alright. Caitlin. This was extraordinarily stupid. Sorry for that. Win. I'm aware that this block didn't make any sense. I really don't want them to draw anymore. Pass here for now. Oh, that dual attack. Yeah, that's fine. And I guess I just managed to do these things. Can't play our Navigator Collectors again because I'm starting to. Random stuff here. And see if we can heal up before they mill out. All of our cards draw cards, but it's fine if we draw cards, but doesn't really matter. Kinda better. Yeah. That. No real point in preventing that. Both of them playing cards. They're like frustrated and don't play any cards anymore. I know they're an AI program stuff in certain ways. We can try. Our problem is to kill off our own units. Like Navigator Collector is one of the worst sources of life skill, life gain. I guess we should have held on to the Caitlyn spell here. Nice. Okay, let's get our first collector down, get the second collector down. Start killing our own units. Life gain. To attack them here. Actually, healthy, gain more life. It's like the way you want to play if you win the game. Play the ephemeral unit to gain 2 more life off of that. Don't want that to happen. Kill our own unit. Life again. So you will never end a fight with no buddy. Life can card in your deck. Roll it out a little bit. Well, it hurts your speed rating, but you should go for speed rating or for actually the game. My advice on this subject. Now let's play another unit. Play Caitlyn because she flips. Navigator Collector is nice. Oh, thank you. Thank you for the life gain. Navigator Collector. And Yeah. Attack here. Und wait around unnecessarily. I just die here anyways next turn that you're like moving out. Then we're definitely worse for them. Swap bot coming down, swapping for this guy. Fine. Alright him. They should attack here. Think. Let's kill them then. Doesn't quite kill them, unfortunately. Back to 30. Now we have to win this turn, then we should fast. Random cards. And we won. I think the fastest way to win here is to attack with an impulse. And that's just game. Whew. Nice. And this one's obviously great, capturing a random unit. Get this free. As well, like this, against Ezreal, you just have to have a decent like late game plan, which you already have, and fine. I like this plunder cost. Yes, it's reroll though to find something more stronger. Didn't find anything stronger. I would actually take this one. Heal for 0 health. And I'm pretty confident we beat Ezreal here. We have like a Nivea, and Ezreal can't strike us. The one thing you want to do as Ezreal versus Ezreal is to delay the level up as much as possible. Ezreal levels up and basically doesn't have any spells in the deck. So basically the power of Ezreal is and costs 1. Spells cost 1. And create a Steady Shock in hand. And then Static Shock creates another thing. We better explain this somehow. So they create a fleeting Static Shock, and then later on they create a fleeting Bruiser Barrage, and basically want to prevent them from leveling up so that they don't get the Bruiser Barrage. One stage I really like is just not playing any units. Especially our hand, like we have this buff. Big waste to not play any units here. Yeah. Basically always shooting you with that damage. Don't really want to play this card out. But we want to capture the other guy with that. Ezreal with our other power, minus 1 minus 0, can't hit us, can't damage us. It's totally fine. And they don't have any spells in their deck. Guess it doesn't matter. They have to shot, I guess. I'm blind. Confirmed blind. But yeah, with this one, I still have time for that one. If you will see that it always like shoot your face randomly with this one. Now with this on the stack, I think this, they have triple gotcha in the deck, one mystic shot and no other spells. Really nothing you have to be afraid of. Pump up my spell shield. Don't even play the Ezreal. The rest. Play our no and elusive. Not score anymore. It's really hard to get perfect score in Ezreal. Basically, all you want to do with that is get an sized lifesteal unit. Basically, win that. Six shot this one. Try again. Like, basically, just playing cards here for the sake of playing cards. Playing random cards in this position, you will. Damage, we can take this out next one with the Stalking Wolf. Because of our attack, our second power, this goes up above. And they still don't work on the level up that much. Or the 5 or 6. Just have such so much damage on the board, so much value. Well. Could like use some other draw, that's another 1 or 2 drop. Maybe it would be nice at some point. Just pass here for now. Anything that's not a 1 or 2 drop be helpful. Well, watch to that. And see what the aesthetic shock so that we can jump block with that one. This for free. Some for free. And that would level up the Ezreal, but it didn't play Ezreal yet. Yep. A little bit afraid of like loose damage here. But it's a little really unfortunate draw. Keep on trying. The one drop. Thank you. Well, let's just take up this fun smith here. Open attack because then our units get healed. My unit, fine. Second fun smith, there's like 3 of those. And can still play Ezreal. How did we like not draw anything? I think I have to do this. Ezreal, I have to like get rid of this fun smith with our Starlitz here. Play Ezreal, that's very good for us. And we need to draw something in late game, like our Nivea, Navigate Collectors, but late game.
How can I help?
And like, and they draw both, all 3 of the Gunsmiths and the top cards. Now they hit the Ezreal level up. Might actually lose this, it's crazy as it sounds. Warn you already. Double Gunsmith hit. Yes!
Nailed it.
This makes sense. That's good.
Firing. No.
Yeah, we definitely need to draw some of our late game here. Crazy. Funsmith. Was Ezreal to block here first, heal our units up again. What is this? Like, I think we drew all of our 1 drops and 2 drops. And let's buff up this one, because it's the biggest one. Let's get healed anyways with our power. Gotcha is this one. Get the fun spell back, but we can heal it again. Kill the first Ezreal at least. Get the action flip, which might actually look for, I don't know, a useful card. Yeah, or a lifesteal card. Do-do. Let's just get rid of this
asset.
Yeah, I can just... Oh, they're stupid. That's fine. Hit and flip. We'll need to find some like late game card here on this Relic of Power. Clicked and then on. Take this though. This one as well. Gunsmiths, the charge is not that scary. Nice as well. Pogobot. So we'll write this one. Oh, it's buffed up. Okay, and again, Ezreal's deck is just like random units, doesn't have any spells at all. Pass. Let's hope there's some more. Yeah, that can't play any cards here. Fill up my unit. Sad. Caitlyn next turn. Flash bomb. Kill them. Yeah, definitely not getting the S for health here. Stuff. More damage. It's fine. Ja, open action. Yeah, the only reason why it went so close is we never saw our Nivea, for example, we never saw our Nevergate Collectors. At the very last moment, we could have seen them. Game. Buff up the right unit. And they don't have any spells. They don't have like... It's just game. GG! And we beat... Caitlyn. And we beat Caitlyn. We beat Ezreal with Caitlyn. Quite nice. Let's see how far these two runs have brought us on our progression. Our way to the mechanic Poro. Everfrost is like a mess. No badges here, but you should put badges anyways if you have like a stronger deck or have like powers unlocked already. Cut cards at you. Okay, and check up how close are we to Pogo guy. Open up some events. Tale of Two Sisters is nice. Wild cards are nice. Okay, like 50 more, 40 more, another one will do it. I will end this video here for now, probably upload the second run later on. Check out these rewards really quick, like rewards. Again, this is the secondary account, so if you just joined in right now. X-Tech Marbles. Chest. Gravecorn. I guess the other one would have been one of the expansion. The I can. So, thank you for watching this part. See you.